हेलो एवरीवन, स्वागत है आपका मेरे चैनल अरिंदम रॉय चौधरी के बेसिक्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स के फंक्शंस पार्ट 3 में, और उम्मीद करते हैं कि आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आएगी। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द रेंज ऑफ अ फंक्शन। सो लेट्स रिकॉल व्हाट इज द रेंज ऑफ अ फंक्शन। इफ वाई इज इक्वल टू एफ एक्स इज द फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स, वेर एक्स इज द इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एंड वाई इज द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, देन वॉट ऑल वैल्यूज ऑफ वाई वी कैन ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द बाई अप्लाइंग द फंक्शन ऑन द परमिसिबल वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स, then that is called the range of a function. So here we have selected some very important questions which have been discussed in JEE over the years. So let's start with some questions. Okay, so the first question is, find the range of the function y is equals to x square plus x plus 2 upon x square plus 1. So this x square plus x plus 2 upon x square plus x plus 1 can be written as 1 plus 1 upon x square plus x plus 1. This is a constant, this is a constant. So we need to focus our attention to only this. So we wrote x square plus x plus 1 as x plus half whole square plus 3 by 4. So again, this is also constant. So we need to see how this varies. X plus 1 by 2 whole square, this can take values from 0 to infinity. It can take its value 0 when x equal to minus half, and it can take its value of infinity when x equal to infinity or x equal to minus infinity. Okay, so the value of this collective denominator varies from 3 by 4 to infinity. So in turn, the value of y varies from 1 plus 1 by 3 by 4 to 1 plus 1 by infinity. So the value of y can vary from 1 plus 4 by 3, it can vary from 1 plus 1 by infinity, that is 1, to 1 plus 1 by 3 by 4, that is 1 plus 4 by 3. So the value of y can vary from y 1 to 7 by 3. Here 1 is not included, as the value of 1 comes when x is equal to infinity or minus infinity, which we can't include. Okay, so this is the range of y, that is from 1 to 7 by 3. Now let's find out the range of function y is equal to x square minus x plus 1 upon x square plus x plus 1. It might look similar to this, but it is not so. We can write this as 1 minus 2x by x square plus x plus 1. Here both of them are varying. Okay, so we took z as equal to 2x by x square plus x plus 1. Now we cross multiplied here, so 2x is equals to zx square plus zx plus z, 0 is equals to zx square plus z minus 2x plus z, applying determinant greater than or equal to 0, so b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, so z minus 2 whole square is greater than or equal to 4z square. So again, when we factorize it, we got 3z minus 2 into z plus 2 is less than 0. When we formulated this on the real line, we got the critical points as z equal to 2 by 3 and z equal to minus 2. And as this is a less than inequality, so the only possible range which comes out here is from z equal to minus 2 to z equal to 2 by 3. So the range will vary from when the value of z is minus 2 and from till the value when z is when the value of z is 2 by 3. Okay, so y ranges from 1 minus 2 by 3 to 1 plus 2. So the value of y ranges from 1 by 3 to 3. This is because there is a negative sign here and not a positive sign. Okay, so now we are going to find out the range of the function y is equals to x square plus 3x plus 2 and divided by x square plus 7x plus 6. I have labeled it as a trick question. You will get to know why. So x square plus 3x plus 2 can be factorized as x plus 1 into x plus 2. X square plus 7x plus 6 can be factorized as x plus 1 into x plus 6. So you might seem very interesting to cancel out this x plus 1 and x plus 1 from numerator and denominator. However, you have to do it, but however, you might note that you can't take the value of x equal to minus 1, as when you take the value of x equal to minus 1, this denominator is also there, that can tend to 0. But we can't let it be, where x is not equal to minus 1. So the value comes out to be x plus 2 upon x minus x plus 6. We can write x plus 2 by x plus 6 as 1 minus 4 by x plus 6. Only this is varying, so this can take value from minus infinity to infinity, anything. Okay, so the value of y can range from anything to anything. Okay, so the value of y ranges from on all real values, but it can't be 1 also, as on happening from 1, the value of x has to take the value of infinity or minus infinity, which we can't include. Okay, so 1 is not included. In addition to this, the value of x can't be equal to minus 1 from this inequality. Okay, so the value of x can't be also equal to minus 1. So 1 minus 4 by 1 minus 4 by 5. So the value of y also can't be equal to 1 by 5. So the range of the function y is equal to x square plus 3x plus 2 upon x square plus 7x plus 6 is equal to all real values, which does not include 1 and 1 by 5. Now the next question is, find out the range of the function sine of log of x square plus e upon x square plus 1. Okay, so this x square plus e upon x square plus 1 we can write as 1 plus e minus 1 upon x square plus 1. Okay, so this is also constant, this is also constant, only this is varying. So we need to shift our focus here. So x square plus 1 can take values from 1 to infinity, everything. So when it takes the value of 1 when x equal to 0, so the value of y is equals to sine of log e 1 plus e minus 1 upon 1. So that is equal to sine of ln e. Ln e is 1, so sine of 1. Okay, so we have got one termination point as sine 1. And when the value of x square plus 1 is tending to infinity when x equal to plus minus infinity, so the value of y is equals to sine of ln 1 plus e minus 1 upon infinity, that is 1. Ln 1 is 0, sine of 0 is 0. So the two endpoints are 0 and sine 1. So the value of y ranges from 0 to sine 1 included, as it comes when x equal to 0, which is included in the set of variables of x, and y equal to 0 is not included because it comes when x equal to infinity, which we can't include. Now let's solve some questions of range which are on the basis of trigonometry. So calculate the range of the function y is equals to 1 upon 3 sine square x plus sine x cos x plus 5. So as 1 is a variable, so we need to shift our focus to our denominator, 3 sine square x plus sine x sine cos x sine x cos x plus 5. We know that the value of a sine x plus b cos x ranges from minus of root of a square plus b square to root of a square plus b square, as discussed earlier. So 3 sine square x can be written as a function of cos of 2x, and sine x cos x can be written as a function of sine of 2x. So when we convert this, 3 sine square x becomes minus 3 by 2 of 1 by 2 sine square x cos x, and this sine x cos x we can write as half of sine 2x plus 13 by 2. 13 by 2 came because we subtracted 3 by 2 from here, so we have to add 3 by 2 here also. 5 plus 3 by 2 equal to 13 by 2. Okay, so y is equals to 1 upon minus 3 by 2 cos 2x plus 1 by 2 sine 2x plus 13 by 2. So the maximum and minimum values of a cos kx plus b cos kx are root of a square plus b square and minus of root of a square plus b square respectively. So the value of y ranges from, so we are basically intrigued upon finding upon the values of maximum and minimum values of this minus 3 by 2 cos 2x plus 1 by 2 sin 2x. So this value can range from minus of root of 3 by 2 square plus 1 by 2 square to root of 3 by 2 square plus 1 by 2 square. Okay, so y ranges from 1 by 13 by 2 minus root 10 by 2 to 1 by 13 by 2 plus 10 root 10 by 2. Okay, so y ranges from 2 by 13 minus root 10 to 2 by 13 plus root 10. On rationalizing it, we get y, multiplying it by its third, so we get y belongs to 26 plus 2 root 10 by 159 and 26 minus 2 root 10 by 159. Okay, so now we are finding out the range of y equal to sec square plus 2 cos square cosec square x. So sec square x can be written as 1 plus tan square x, and 2 cosec square x can be written as 2 plus 2 cot square x. Okay, so the value of y becomes tan square x plus 2 cot square x plus 3. We know that cot square x is the inverse of tan square x. So on applying AMGM inequality, tan square x plus 2 cot square x by 2 is greater than or equal to tan square x into 2 cot square x, that is equal to root of 2. Okay, so this is always greater than root 2. So the value of this can range from 2 root 2 to infinity. As when the value of x is equals to either 0, if it's a multiple of pi by 2, then the value of y can be infinity. Okay, so the value of y ranges from 3 plus 2 root 2 to infinity, 3 included, as when this inequality sign is equal. Okay, and it is equal to infinity when x is an integral multiple of pi by 2. Agar aapko ye video pasand aaye to kijiye like, comment, share aur subscribe. Functions part 4 will be out very soon. Till then, stay tuned.